always answer a lot of your questions. And so we're basically just going to go through that agreement really quickly, and I'll tell you the differences between the teams as we do. So there are three things that we promise that your dancer will receive. This has actually been the same in my agreement for the past 17 years. These sentences have changed since the studio opened, so it's important to us that we try to abide by those. Number one is skilled and caring instruction at all dance classes, activities, performances, competitions. So anytime you're with us, we want you to feel like your child or your children are in good hands and that your instructor and your staff cares about them. Number two, a disciplined and positive learning environment. Especially nowadays, I don't know if anyone else has noticed this, but it seems harder to raise kids. Anybody? Just me? Like my 21-year-old versus my 14 and 11-year-olds, man, it's totally different. And so it takes a village, and that's what we're trying to provide for you, is a second support system for your kids. We really do become family, not just the dance studio, so a disciplined and positive learning environment is important to us.
There's a crowd right here.
There's a crowd.
Let's make a new row right here.
Oh, yeah, just come in the middle. Yeah, it's fine. And then third is a well-rounded dance education. And a lot of that has to do with you as a parent and what you choose to take advantage of. We offer every major style, but obviously, if all of that doesn't work well with your family's personal schedule, then you take what pertains to you. But just know that it is offered a well-rounded dance education. In fact, we're the only local competitive dance studio that offers every single style. So, pretty cool. And then these are our requirements, and this is pretty much the same no matter what team your kiddo is on. Number one, dancers will attend and participate fully in every class they are enrolled in. I'm just going to take a few minutes to talk about that. As much as you can, try to plan your appointments, social plans, vacations, other extracurricular opportunities outside of the dance schedule. We try and get the dance schedule out to you fairly early. Summer schedule, for example, I think it's been out for a month and a half-ish around there, and then your requirements for a lot of you have gone out in the last 2 weeks, and those of you who've just made a team and you aren't sure what your child's funding requirements are, those are going out this upcoming week. Our fall schedule, we're crossing the fingers, will be out within a couple of weeks so that you'll have a 2.5 month notice of our fall schedule. And so just along those lines, just try to start to plan the schedule outside of that. It might not seem like a big deal, but crazy enough, whenever your dancer is gone, it affects more than just your dancer. And we also ask that if you have to leave early for any reason, try to avoid that because the last 10 to 15 minutes of class is the most productive time in class. And if you're late, the first 10 to 15 minutes is what makes us ensure that your dancer is going to be sick. If they're not properly warmed up, that could affect their safety. So the beginning and end of class are really important. I just want to reiterate that if you're on a competition team, please don't downgrade your classes, ballet, jazz, hip-hop, tap, ballroom. Please make sure that your acro, please make sure that you're making an effort to get to your technique in this class. Two tardies equal an absence. And each time we have an absence, we try to have some sort of small consequence for it. And I like to put out a disclaimer here that I don't decide what is a good reason or a bad reason for missing dance. There are excellent reasons of every shape and form. And so I decide if it's good and a bad reason. It's just an absence is an absence. And there's typically a consequence for it. And it's not necessarily a bad thing. It's just the only way that I don't have to be a judge. An absence is an absence. And then usually there's a consequence for it. Be on time. Participate for the duration of every class. Wear proper attire. We're going to talk just a minute on proper attire. So in ballet, we ask for pink leotards, lies, black leotards, pink tights, and pink leather or canvas ballet shoes. No specific brand, no specific style. You can go to Walmart, you can order on Amazon, you can get a fancy dancy $60 black leotard. Honestly, whatever you want is totally fine. Every year, we struggle with getting our kids to consistently wear their ballet clothing. We're getting better than ever, but probably the biggest struggle right now is shoes. So if you can please make sure that your dancer has their ballet shoes with their names on the insides of them. If I had a dollar for every ballet shoe I pick up, that would make me over $1 I need. help remind them to stay off the equipment. And then just tiny things. Don't touch the mirrors or clean anybody's really paint on. Don't chew gum or bring food or beverages into the studio. Don't enter the studio during other classes. No cell phones for our older kiddos. No cell phones in the studios. And then just a few rules. I'll just read through these. Instructors may thank you for bringing that up. If you pay your fall, like your September through May tuition in full in September, then you actually don't have tuition in May. May is free. So if you're the kind of person who likes to pay things up front, mm-hmm. save a whole month's worth of tuition, mm-hmm. and it's just our September through May. Good question. Just the September number. Yeah. By that same token, if you pay your summer, if you are an elite team dancer and you're required to do the all excess pass,
you could have paid and got your audition fee waived.
That was at auditions.
Yes.
Okay. But it was on your audition sheet when you figured out, so hopefully it's there. Any other questions? Let me agree with that. Okay, you guys are awesome. Okay, a few other things that I wanted to touch base on. The competition schedule, elite dancers were going to Rebel and Billings, Hollywood Dance Jams in Utah, and Energy this year in Orange County, California. Those are just our elite teams. Why am I not returning to Seattle? Because it's the first weekend in January. I can't believe I did that. That would have been like such a great one to go back to. But for those of you that are wondering, that's why I didn't choose to go to Seattle. We will not have a question of ownership at that time.
I don't know.
So
can
that's
you hear your feedback, please?
Yeah. Rebel in Billings in March.
Welcome.
That's right. Yeah. Energy in Orange County, California. Okay. And Hollywood Dance Jams, which will also be new to us in Utah in.
I think the end of March.
March as well. I can't quite remember.
I can't remember that.
Yeah. But those are your three basics. And Hollywood Dance Jams is a sister to Hollywood Live. And it's a brand new city. There next year, so we're going to get the shots. Yep. And then rubies, emeralds, diamonds, legacy gems, little gems, your competition and performance schedule. That one sometimes can take just a little bit longer, and the reason why is some of the local competitions don't even have their dates out yet. So I do give our elite kids a little bit of an idea, because those are usually the 1 to 2 years in advance, but our ruby, emerald, diamonds, legacy gems, I might need a little bit more time. Questions on that? Yeah.
Three
competitions
are
just legends. Yes. Yeah, we'll do the three convention competitions, and then we do go to regular competitions. Yeah. Yeah, you're welcome. Yes. Well. But I did read a baseball book that Skip shares Martin, and it's called The Matheny Manifesto. So this baseball coach guy, he wrote a manifesto of what his baseball players, and more importantly, his baseball parents, have to follow in order for them to be on his team. So I read this book, got super inspired by it, and I have the manifesto. And this is the, you're going to laugh, but I'm actually going to type this up, send it out to you, and I'm going to ask you to sign it, as important as your team agreement, because we're all in this for the same reason, for our own children to become the best that they can be and be in the best environment they can. How many of these kids are going to grow up and be professional dancers? One out of every 500, maybe? But they're all going to grow up and be humans, right? Parents and co-workers and all of that. So that's what we are trying to raise, is really awesome humans, and we're trying to do it through the power of dance. So that's where my silly little manifesto is coming up. And I'll just touch on a couple of things that I would really like to be brought to home. So one is our core values program here at the studio. So we have a core value for every month, and they're very strategically planned. For instance, in the spring, there's 1 month where our core value is resilience. So that's when you're just starting to get all like this dancer. And you probably are a singer too. We kind of have to gone, you know, doing a competition. And so the month is focused on resilience. There's a month that's focused on love. There's a month that's focused on confidence, that all kinds of things. And that's the first thing that I just wanted to reiterate, is we really believe in those core values. They're really important. And you can try to reiterate those with your dancer at home, I promise that will help them. And the second thing is just to remember our culture, kind of what we stand for. That's the whole jacket thing that I already explained, your mind, body, spirit, your strong technical foundation, and leaving a legacy. Our past dancers have left us a really great legacy. And our dancers now, believe it or not, their time will be up soon, and you want them to leave a legacy for future dancers. And then I think third is just for us to teach our kids to be really, really, really kind. The biggest problem I think our dancers have is like getting feelings or repeating thoughts or sentences from parents that they've heard at home. It's not necessarily what happens here all the time. And so that is going to manifesto. A manifesto is stay positive about what's happening in the studio. Don't talk about other people's children. They have absolutely no bearing on your children. Your focus is on your child. And so it doesn't matter what Susie does. It's not going to have an effect on your child. If you think that there's one person who has the power to make an entire team suck, you are completely incorrect. Yeah? And if you think there's one person that's so great that if we don't have her on our team, we're doomed. There's no shining star. You're absolutely incorrect. And we don't need that. Nobody makes you team ever. And I know that sounds horrible and a little bit mean, but the team will go on with or without our diva. And we will be strong. Yeah? What we want to do is be building each other up. Okay? And so that's kind of my little manifesto. That being said, if there's ever a concern you have for your child, I am open door. And those of you who've had to have a conversation with me in the past, you know I want to hear your feelings. I really do. Even if I don't get heated because I'm pretty passionate about your team and your children, I do want to hear it. I'd rather you say it to me, and together we can work for a resolution. That's the end. That's my abbreviated version. Might be a little fancier than that. Questions on any of that? Yes.
I'm a bit confused. My daughter got a little dense, and it's like past this time.
Oh, no, you're great. Okay, so anybody.